Hello friends, good week. How are you? Vladimir here, and this is the weekly review for the last week of April and the beginning of May. May, as many traders know that, looking on the historical view, of course, is normally bearish months. Bearish months for major pairs, but mainly for the indices. Let me show you the charts. Take a look here. This is Dow Jones, for example. Okay, 2012 drop down on May. 2011 drop down on May. 2010 drop down. 2009 it was a bit up and then down. 2008 drop down. Fast drop down starting on May. 2007 bit up and then a bump down. 2006 down. Is that what we are heading? As I was talking about on the last weeks, I said it not once that the higher the indices will push, the worse it will be actually to the economy at the end. I think, and I know that I'm not the only one that thinks the same, that this rise is not a real rise. Okay, it's not real money rise, and the higher the worse, the higher the bigger will be the reality that the market will wake up from its dream, it's dreaming right now. And that's why on some place I hope that the down move, like 10-20% only down move, will come as soon as possible, just to avoid the crash that will come if this natural cycle, natural correction, will not happen. If we continue from here and we don't and we will not complete the cycle in May, June or July, then August, September, October, as I said, could turn to be disaster months, and that's what we all want to avoid. But I will talk later about indices. Now let's start with the forex pairs and the opportunities we have. For a while I'm talking about the yen pairs. As you know, take a look on this beautiful candle created on a dollar yen. Let's go back here without the channels, okay, without the time and history view here. That's a perfect kicker with engulfed a beautiful hammer on the previous week. We have more than 20 candles right on the weekly chart, so let's say, in my point of view, the drop down is about to begin. Going to the daily chart, we have even more interesting picture. From my point of view, that's a megaphone. Making that megaphone means the dollar yen should at the end drop all the way down to the meeting between these two points. So how I see the things, I see the dollar yen moving down here. Maybe it's not going to be straight, but maybe we'll see some push up again and then a down move to complete 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spots. Then I see some pull back up and then bam, another bump down back to 90 zone. In my point of view, we should be looking for sell opportunities, at least as long as the psychological 100 level holds so strong as it does right now. Going to the 4-hour chart, we can say for the first time we have a bearish convergence. Classical? For sure not. The MACD here just kissed the zero line, it never crossed up, so it's still a bearish convergence, which means we should be looking to sell every push up. Now this push up could go back to 98.40, could go back to 98.90 or so, the 20 MA, or could simply create small flag, crash down and continue all the way to the next important support. And that could be here, 96 plus, then we have, of course, 94 plus, then we have 92 plus, and then we have the last level. I will be looking, that's 91 minus, closer to 90, closer to the psychological 90 level. So in my point of view, sell the rally. Each rally you have, go and make a sell. Of course, intraday rally. If you want more how to deal with the convergence scenario and what it means. Sell the rally watch for my book in Amazon. I know most of you have it. For those of you who still don't have it, it's time straighten the line with the rest of the followers. You can learn everything it means to trade convergences. Again, sell the rally right from this scenario, as long as the 100 level psychologically holds. Based on the weekly 20 candles right, dollar yen should visit all the way down to the lower band of the Bollinger's. Based on that, we have also divergence on the extreme. So again, that's how I see the prices moving. Maybe pull, small pullback, down move again, up, down, crook, and then coming back to this zone at the end. I think that this spike trend line starting from here will at the end meet us together with the final direction, final target of the dollar yen. Sell the rally. Of course, it's relevant to all of the yen pairs. Euro yen looks amazing, pretty much the same. Pound yen looks wonderful. This one just did not create a lovely pattern yet, but still the sell is screaming there. Maybe it will push a bit higher, 154 or so, maybe a bit higher even, but the down move is not a question of if, it's a question of when exactly. I can go on and on. New Zealandian yen, Australian yen, Canadian yen, I can continue and never stop. Swiss yen, right? All will then will say exactly the same. So in my point of view, it's about to begin. And if you remember what I compared on the previous weekly review, 1997, then it started because of the Japanese yen. When I say that, I mean major correction on the financial markets and a drop on the indices. Maybe after 16 years it's about to happen again. As we know, some economical cycle comes every 7-8 years in average, not always 7-8, but in average. Maybe this 16 years will be very, very important number as well. So that's about the yen pairs, and that's the trades I am following and I am talking about. This is a cycle for a pretty long while right now, for a few months already. Now let's go to the other opportunities. Euro against the pound. I've been talking about this pair, you remember that. Right now, something interesting happening. MACD is Bollinger Bands is crossing, it's crossed right here. This candle closed below the weekly 20 MA. This is a pretty bearish sign. RSI on weekly still did not cross the 50s though, but that's a bearish sign. As I was talking for a long time now, this line should be tested. We are on the way to there. How it should act from here, in my point of view, and you know my point of view, I've been talking about that for several weeks as well. This should go down. Right now, it is breaking the Bollinger Band, breaking the support. So, in my point of view, we are going down. Every rally here should be a sell opportunity. Going to the 4-hour charts, we see there is kind of continuing divergence. Every rally here, back to 0.8440, maybe back to the trend line or so, should provide us a beautiful sell opportunity. Then I think it could create here 1, 2, maybe 3 days flag, trying to play inside, then break down, pushing that to this range finally, and from here we'll have to stop and to reanalyze the pair. From here it might turn to be another buy opportunity, which will take the pair to new highs again. We will see that, we'll follow that. Right now it's still early, and again, in my opinion, sell the rallies. That's what it is here. It looks good. It looks good. Looks very, very correct. And between these two lows, this is a convergence. After this sideway move, right, that's the first time we have a convergence here with the break. Right? Classical? Of course not. But it's still a convergence. It is still the bearish sign. That's about the euro pound. What does it mean on the pound and the euro? How it's going to affect? Now, the pound dollar, if you followed my post on the blog, let me show you that. I've been talking about the pound dollar, right? And I was looking for that on the 24th of April, the last Wednesday, to break down. Take a look, right? That was what I was looking for, okay? That's the attempt to go higher. Okay, that's what I saw, and that's what I saw. There's going to be a breakdown, which will lead us to this move. Okay, I was looking for a break below this 152, actually. Never happened, and instead of that, we got here, as you can see from here, a push up. This push up happened because the news on Thursday with the GDP, the domestic growth was 0.3%, which means Britain avoided a recession. After two negative quarters, finally they got positive number. It's only 0.3, but look how positive it affected the pound. Don't forget and don't be confused. One of the reasons Britain had issues was strong pound value. They decreased it pretty amazingly down to 1,000 pips. Right now, it's corrected half of the way. Trust me, they will not want to strengthen their currency again too much, and that's why, in my point of view, we should be looking to sell opportunities to the pound dollar. How and where? Well, let me quickly explain what do we have. This is, for the first time, a bearish convergence, which means we should be looking for sell opportunities. Going to the daily chart, after this continuing divergence that pushed the pair back to 20 MA, as we always look for, right now it's pushing up. But the divergence is still here. Of course, it can push a bit higher, but the divergence will just follow that. And if it pushes higher, RSI will come to extreme as well. Taking a look on the Fibonacci's, it will bring us to the next resistances. That's around 156 and then around 157 plus. There, I think we should be looking for the next sell. Look for the combination with this divergence. Once it gets a stop, MACD turns to bearish slope on the histogram and we get a bearish candle pattern, it's time to jump in. In my point of view, it's only a question of time. It is not a question of if that pound dollar will drop down. How it means about the euro dollar? Well, euro dollar is a bit tricky. I prefer to stay away. I still think bearish. There is a flag right now. This flag should be broken down and we could see a pretty beautiful drop to the 127 or even lower. Right now, if today or tomorrow, Lita will build a government with Berlusconi, that's not a good sign from Italy, and that could affect the euro dollar pretty immediately. Don't be surprised if it will even open with a gap down. So it all could affect the euro pairs. And if the euro pound will drop down, it will be mainly right now because of the euros still, not because of the pound. So that's my view about the majors. Now, another very interesting opportunity I have here, that's the euro against the Australian. Euro Australian is very tricky. From one side, there is a trend line of the spikes, still was not tested, and that's around 128, a bit higher than 128. From the other side, despite of the last 2 days stop, MACD slope histogram is still bearish. Stochastic still very bearish. So two things could happen from here. A final push up to create a continuing divergence here, and then a drop down, completing one, two, three, four, five ways, and then all the way down again. The second thing could happen, this will stop after two, three candles. And we will see a breakdown below this 126 finally, and then it will lead us for another drop. Follow this pair on the daily chart and the current flag and look for the sell opportunities. Again, bad news from Europe will drop dead down pretty strong. That's another great opportunity I have on my list. Another one will be pound against the franc. It's pretty much vice versa to the euro pound. I think it could push a bit higher, and it could go for the Bollinger Band duplication on the daily chart, which means around the resistance around 147, maybe a bit higher, closer to the 200 moving average. Just watch this trend line here, right? That's very steep trend line, several resistances on the way, starting from 146.50 and higher. Look for sell opportunities. Right now, that's a bullish convergence right here, which means from this range we will see a bearish correction. The bearish correction could be 40 points correction, but in my point of view, it could be all the way back to closer to this support right here around 144.75. It should bring us back to there, so it's 100 points, or all the way down to the daily 20 MA. That's my opinion. The fact that on the 4 hour chart we have 20 candles right already makes it look even better. So if we get this push up, it will be more than 20 candles right, and then the drop down to the trend line will be fast, up and down, right? Alternatively, if it completes a break below the current support here, 145.60, and holds below that, it could make the drop to the support I am looking to, the trend line and the support I'm looking to, like 140, 475, even from here. That's another wonderful opportunity in my point of view. And another one that will be the cat against the franc. Also, we have very beautiful trend line setting right here. That's pretty much a channel, right? We have a bearish hidden divergence forming already here. If it pushes a bit higher, it's going to be band to band going down to the 4 hour chart. This push up could create for us the beautiful divergence right here. A push up, a down, a bearish sign with a bearish candle, and bearish turnaround on the histogram, and we get a drop down 20 MA on a daily chart, or the even the support here on the 4 hour chart will be the first target. Then of course it could drop all the way down to, based on the channel. If this channel will be broken up, of course that would be a sign for us to stay away from this pair. Now that's another great opportunity I see on my list. Now, quick update. You remember my views about the pound New Zealandian. In my point of view, it's turning bullish. I want to see how this month is about to end. If this month ends bullish, that could be a good sign for this divergence to start the up move all the way to the highs I was talking about for a few weeks in a row. I am bullish in my views. In other words, I would say a break above this trend line here and a break above this resistance here with a monthly, of course, bullish candle should open the doors for a strong up move to happen. That's my opinion about this one. And of course, there is an Australian New Zealandian, and I was talking about that also a long time. That's a beautiful straight move. Now it's a Bollinger Band duplication. There are several supports on a weekly chart. As you can see here, 121, 120, 119, every 100 points, very strong support. I think it's creating a bottom, maybe not from the current place, maybe a bit lower, but a beautiful bullish cycle is about to come, and this cycle will take us back for something like 250 up to 400 pips at least. I keep my bullish opinion. A few words about the gold and the silver. Well, as long as on the gold this trend line holds, the gold could rise all the way to 1530, 1540, even 1580. All the way. If this trend line will be broken and holds below, this could be bearish sign. Daily chart probably is going to create here a bearish hidden divergence. Maybe now, maybe a bit higher. That's why I follow this trend line. And of course, with the hidden divergence, it means new lows could be created. Same with the silver. Right now, there is no sign for a bearish candle, but so it still could push higher back to 25, 60, 80, 26 even. maybe even 2650, and then to complete this bearish hidden divergence on a daily chart with the daily trend line we have right here, right, and then make another drop down. That's another interesting thing to follow, of course. Natural gas will be the last commodity. Well, you know my opinion, I was talking about it a lot. On a weekly chart we have a pretty strong divergence. I think it will drop down all the way to weekly 20 MA. In case it pushes a bit higher, and it could happen, 440, 460, 480, each of these levels is the next level to watch for this divergence to happen and to drop down to come. The trend line is the final target. It should is the first target it should go to. Then it might break this channel it's forming right here and push it all the way duplication even back to 3. Right? Of course it will take time as we're talking here about the weekly chart. And a few words about the indices. Well, May is here, is coming, not here yet. In my point of view, the moment it breaks and holds below 14,600 for the Dow Jones, this time should bring it strong down. We follow the first trend line right here, okay, with the support, and at the end I do expect it to drop all the way from here back to this trend line. In other words, I see a lot of bears coming inside. If it pushes a bit higher, then of course we follow the weekly continuing divergence forming, and then we'll be talking about the next highs. Same about the Nasdaq, which is still forming kind of type of head and shoulders, and same about the S&P 500, which also looks like building a head and shoulders on a daily chart. I think down, and I think it's about to begin right the beginning of this week. That's my opinion. And but with all that, there is one thing, one stock I think it worth to start to invest in, and that's Apple. Even though I think it still could drop lower to 360, maybe even all the way down to 300, I think it's time to jump in already. First of all, it has 20 candles right already. It has a continuing divergence on the weekly chart, and it has, well, you can see it here, I don't know why, but it has a bullish hidden divergence on a monthly chart. From my point of view, it's time to invest it very careful, because it might drop lower. Every drop down of something like 60 up to 100 points should be just an opportunity to buy more from Apple. I think that within the next several months it will create here in between the current level down to 300, maybe even 260, it will create a bottom and take us all the way back to 530 or even higher. That's my opinion. So in my point of view, this is a time to start buying Apple shares. That's pretty much all, friends. That's the greatest opportunities I see. We have a lot, as you saw. The new things we have is pound franc, CAD franc, euro Aussie is great one. Of course, we have the majors. We have the yen pairs. We have the gold and the silver and the natural gas. We have the indices. For those of you who trade oil, then also on oil, I think there is still a place to go a bit higher to create a daily bearish hidden divergence. Once it completes it, and when it completes it, it will be good time to sell. It could be in between 94 up to 96 or so, 96.50 maybe even. Complete this bullish move and start drop down for something like 300-400 points. That's my opinion about the oil. That's all, friends, for the upcoming week. Before I finish, just a quick reminder, take a look. This week is very, very fundamental week, but the main thing you have to pay attention to that on Wednesday, the European banks will be and holiday due to the Labor Day. On a Friday, we have non-farm payrolls. Also, a lot to remember. On Thursday, we have the interest rate in Britain and Europe. No, not Britain this time, sorry, just Europe this time. And we have trade balance on USA, but again, it's not all. And on Wednesday, 2 p.m. EST time, we have the Federal Reserve, the Bank of USA meeting. And I guess everyone is looking to that, as everyone wants to hear what Bernanke has to say regards the QE number 3. That would be all, friends, for this week. Thank you very much for your time watching this video. I hope you find it very interesting. Every comment will be very appreciated. So if you have anything to say, to share your opinion, on just comment on my views, I will be happy to reply them. Just comment on the blog or on Facebook, whatever is better for you. Thank you once again. Have a wonderful week. Yours, Vladimir Rybakov.